Right, I'm going to try and show my suggested method for removing the seized injectors. As you can see, I've successfully managed to remove three, and knowing the pain that it is, I thought I'd do a short video to try and show how I've done it. Right, I've attempted to cut through what I can using a Dremel. Some fella here. And I've got a hydraulic puller. It's over there. But I've also got the Renault dealer tool, which I think will work. So I'm going to attempt to remove this hydraulic, this seized injector using the Renault tool. Obviously, if I don't have any joy, I'll have to revert to the hydraulic puller. But at £150 for this kit, as opposed to several hundreds for the hydraulic puller, it may work out to be a more affordable option for people that are stuck. I'd already snapped the top of the injector. There's just a small amount of thread left on it. So I'm hoping by cutting through the bulk of it here, coming in from this side and from the back, that I've managed to weaken it sufficiently that I can remove the top of the injector to where the cut mark is, as you see it. As you can see, I've just got the basic wind on touch. So I'm going to give it a go now, and fingers crossed it'll work. Right, it's just cracked. This is a 30mm nut, obviously 30mm socket with a breaker bar. And as I said, it appears as though it's busted the top. There we go. Right, that's what I'm left with. That's the piece that broke off, as I wanted. And just as you can see, that's the kit. And its part number, if anyone's interested, is 1966. Right. On to the next bit. Right, I've put a couple of bolts in here loose, just to keep the rubbish out of the screws, because we need those later. I've just put a flat wheel on a 4-inch grinder, just to bring this face down smooth. The reason being is because this tool is something I made, which allows you to make sure that the hole as you drill it is central. I'll take that apart in a minute and give you the dimensions for that. You can either get one made or attempt to make one yourself. It wasn't particularly hard. Right, sorry about the shaky video. Firstly, it's my first attempt at YouTube. Secondly, I'm doing it on my phone, which isn't ideal. This is just if someone wants to get an idea as to the dimensions. But as you can see, this piece here, from one side to the other, has been reduced to 32mm to allow it to go in between the bolt up stands. This is a 10mm internal diameter bearing, 8mm I believe, high, 26 outside diameter. This hole here is 29mm internal diameter, to allow it to go over the over this ring, the top ring of the injector. And the internal hole, I made 19mm, to allow it to go over the body of the injector, which is the injector diameter. The other face, this is 26mm internal. It's 10mm deep, as you can see on here. To be honest with you, it could probably do with being a little bit deeper, 10mm. And then I'll just basically put a little recess in there. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. A little recess, just basically to retain the circlet to hold the bearing in place. As I said, once that goes over the injector, that allows you to make sure that as you drill, you're drilling reasonably center. The problem is if you drill it as it is, these holes that are already existing run off at all different angles, and you'll find that the hole as you attempt to drill it will follow those. It won't stay true. I'll explain how I've managed to devise a method to get around that. Anyway, I'll put it all back together and we'll proceed. Just quickly show how the assembly would sit over the injector body. As you can see, if that's turned upside down, that sits in there quite snug. It's probably due to being tidied up a little bit. I guess I've abused it for the last three, but effectively it ensures that the drill bit and the whole assembly sits centre to the injector body. Obviously, this part of the injector body is the part that seizes in. Absolute bloody nuisance, poxy idea, but that aside, nice vehicles. So, right, here we go. Right, in order to ensure that this is as centre as it can be, place it over. Obviously, this is the purpose of the cutouts, to stand either side of these bolts. Right. This is the following day. Unfortunately, some of the recording that I did yesterday didn't come out particularly well. I'm obviously a better mechanic than I am a Spielberg double. Right, so I'm just going to run through the basics. As you can see, I've already this is already all removed, so I'm just kind of doing a mock just to sort of show you what needs to be done. The top of the injector, if I remove the cord, it's already been removed. The top of the injector sits something like that. The intent is to try and remove this assembly, to get it flush with the top of the injector core, this sleeve, which fortunately I've got one that I managed to take out, and if I can find it there. This is one that I managed to remove prior, and then I used it as a donor to sort of investigate what I needed to do, what sizes I needed, etc. So that's pretty much how it will sit when you've taken the top off. In order to get the hole central to this, as I was saying, that's when this is used. Now that sits over the top of that, remembering that obviously that'll all be flush. That sits, the base of this will be flush with the cam carrier, and this will be held central by the base of the base of the tool and the ring of the injector sleeve, if you like. So that sits in there. Now, in order to get the hole centre, I tried different methods, but the fail-proof method is to use. this fella. As you can see, it's a four-ended, four-faced, whatever you want to call it. It's an end mill piece, and the set that I've been using is this lot here. There, you can see there's an assortment. But I'm pretty sure that, well, I know for a fact they can be bought individually. The only two that are needed are this one, which is the M10. And for the purposes of tapping, this one, which is M12. So, returning to where I was, start initially by using the M10. And as I said yesterday, you only need to drill for sort of 20 seconds at a time. Once you've sort of drilled for 20, 25 seconds or so, remove this, clean the swarf. If there's any swarf set in there, it will damage the bit. It will just skate on the shavings rather than actually drilling new material. Once you've got down to, as I said yesterday, the top of the piezo crystal, if you're able to remove the crystal, do. Once you've got the whole centre, part of the problem is that the depth of this tool and the depth of the drill bit are pretty similar. So you're not going to get a huge amount of drilling depth into this once you've trimmed it level. So the thing to do is make sure that the hole center, which this piece will help you to do, and then continue manually, obviously taking into account the remaining parallel with the injector. You can see as you're drilling, looking, you know, by eye, you can see if you're sort of remaining central. Once you've got down so far with 10, then change to the 12. Do much the same thing, go down through. As I said, if you're able to get to the piezo crystal and remove it, as you saw yesterday with the easy out or whatever the case may be, then it will be more advantageous. But return to the tap, which I think I put away. Oh, hang on. Is it this one? Yeah, I believe it's that one. Which is the 14 mil, so M14 times 1.5 pitch thread. Obviously, you can use any thread, any pitch that you have to end. It's commonly available. Tap down as far as you can. I showed on the video yesterday. Get it in there, get the pulling tool, and you should be able to start pulling away. Later on today, I'm going to attempt to remove the remaining cores, which are still in there. I'm going to see if I can devise some sort of tooling to try and remove these pieces. Obviously, the advantage now is if I don't have any joy, as I said yesterday, the head, or the cam carrier, only goes as far as this lip, as best I can tell. So this piece upwards is the cam carrier, from there downwards is the head. So this can be removed, which gives you access to this on a bench or a multitude of other options. But as I said, I'm going to try and to attempt to remove these two remaining cores. And if I'm successful, then I shall record it and either put it as a different video or stitch it to the end of this one. Thanks for watching. Right. Battery went flat on this bloody phone. But as you can see, that's threaded, ready to go. And this is part of a puller assembly that I bought. Nothing special. And the actual complete kit is here, and I believe it's made by a mechanic. Yeah, I'll just turn it around the right way. It served my purpose for now. I've had to make some adjustments. A few of the pieces I tried to modify and failed. But after trial and error, 3 weeks, I've managed to successfully make a tool that's capable of doing the job. Now this piece of threaded bar actually started life as a bolt. It was this bolt here, M16 bolt. I cut the head off, cut that piece off, I trimmed it down to 75mm and then threaded it. That's M14 times 1.5. It's high tensile, you can tell just by the weight of the bolt. And that works out to be more than adequate to pull without the distortion or breakage that I was getting with this kit, as you can see on here. Because this is high carbon, it just wasn't capable of taking the forces. That was one, in fairness, that I'd machined down to make it M14 times 1.5. This is one that I attempted to make M12. M12 just wasn't strong enough and it sheared. So I've settled on M14. 1.5 high tensile, and I've managed to successfully pull two of the injectors that are now out. So I'm going to put that in the hole and see how we go. Said I was going to try using the manual Renault tool as opposed to the hydraulic puller. It's quite critical when you put this piece in and this piece. Everything's as tight as it can be without obviously running the risk of breaking anything. You know, I put a punch through this hole and use this to wind down onto that, and that in turn forced into there, and it's nice and rigid now. You know, everything will break and bust and fall apart at the blink of an eye. So it's critical to get everything as tight as it can be. Alright, so I'm now going to put the legs on and the base, and there we go with the puller again. Okay, just to let you know, I had problems getting this to line up on this peg with the hydraulic system, because this is only M14, it's a lot more narrow. There's a lot more space in here for this to be able to sort of move around. All I did was I loosened this manually by spanner, 17mm, couple of turns, pop this on, and then just tighten it back up, and we're good to go. A word of caution, when they're tight enough, this whole assembly has a tendency of sort of jumping out. It goes off like a gun. So I've kind of got wires now, and I use these bands, cable ties, bits of rope, whatever you can find really, just to try and secure it. So as if it does go, it doesn't sort of shoot up in the sky, put a hole in your ceiling, take your light out, and give you concussion whilst it's at it. So there you are. Hopefully this can be seen. The assembly split on the side there, which isn't a problem, because we're actually looking to remove this lower section completely to get it flush down to the base of this. This is all part and parcel. It's not an issue. Obviously it would have been better if it came off clean, but it just means we'll have to get the Dremel out again. That's the split piece bust off. I'm gonna wash the hammer and bolster. Again, the metal's reasonably soft, so it didn't take a great deal of breaking. These pieces here. What we'll do now is use the Dremel again, just to try and get this flush to that lip, and then back on with the hole centre. And then the next issue, you can just see the top of it now, is the piezo crystal, which is, I'll try and point it out. The piezo crystal is that piece there. And to be honest with you, they're a bloody nuisance, because you can't drill it manually as you would normally, because it rotates and the drill can't get purchased. Hence the reason it's, again, it would be so easy to use a manual drill and to sort of slide off track and, you know, just never ever get the bloody thing out. But there we go. Right, I'll turn the video back on after I've cleaned that up with the Dremel. I broke a couple of the pieces off that were proud. Made life a bit easier. I broke them off with the cold chisel and the hammer, and then just used the Dremel just to sort of tidy it up. It's not completely flush, but it's it would just make life a lot easier with the drill and the tap. That's the idea of it. All right, so I'm going to go back to the M12 four-edged flute piece. In fact, I'm going to put the centre back on it and start with a 10mm, just to sort of give me a bit of a purchase. But again, it's not overly. The material isn't overly tough. The hardest part you'll find when you get there is the top of the piezo crystal. But I'll show you how to take that out shortly. Alright. There's the little centering tool. And there's the 10mm four face flute. Should slot straight in. Nice centre hole. There you go. Alright. Revamp. The 10mm piece isn't deep enough to go through here and actually make purchase with the end of there. So I'm going to take this off and just manually go straight in there with a 12mm. We've already got a hole in place. So, get this thing off. And obviously as you drill, just try to be mindful of the fact that you need to remain central. So as you're drilling, just, you know, remain parallel. With the injector, you know, the angle of the injector, and drill away until you get down to the piezo crystal, which I shall show you shortly. Maybe 15mm you need to drill down before you can actually get to the outer diameter of the crystal, which then allows it to be pulled out. Obviously, once it's pulled out, you can then drill into the remainder of the injector quite easily. Right, so here goes. Okay, you can now clearly see the two holes within a sort of disc. That's the top of the piezo crystal. Effectively, that should be able to pull out from there. Just to let you know, in between video shots, I'm probably drilling for about 35, maybe 40 seconds at a time and then cleaning it out. So it's not taking any great deal of time. A lot of mess, a lot of swarf. but as I said before, it's not an overly tough material. It's quite easy to drill, so it's all about keeping it centre. Right, I've just tried to have a go at picking the crystal out as it is. My pick isn't deep enough to get in there to actually get a purchase. Plus, I think it's kind of sort of rebated behind the remnants of the injector assembly about, the injector body. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to tap that back to M14 times 1.5, put the rod back in there, and hopefully pull this assembly away from this ring. Hopefully pull the whole lot out, but remove this assembly above the ring. Once this is gone, I know from the previously that it's quite easy then to pop the crystal out and drill down into the remaining part of the injector. Right. Hopefully you can see that's threaded. The hole, when I was drilling the hole, I think the hole's reamed slightly. It's not quite the 12mm that I wanted it to be, to allow for a nice tight snug fit. The reason why I'm saying is because the tap went in far easier than it has done previously. I think it will be okay, but I meant to say, incidentally, when you're drilling with the 12mm mill bit, the four edged flute bit, effectively, if whilst you're doing it you see any smoke start to come out from the hole that you're drilling, don't panic. It's just where you've hit the diesel pocket. There's some sort of pocket of diesel set within the injector. It's actually a good sign, so you needn't panic if you see it. Right, ready to try putting it again, complete with the rubber bands in place. Right, hopefully it'll pull that piece out. Yeah. So my suspicions were right. It hadn't threaded particularly well, and it just basically pulled the thread. So I'm going to drill deeper, probably another 20 or 30 mil, drill into the piezo crystal, re-tap it and go again. As you can see, the crown, or the lid, or whatever you may want to call it, of the piezo crystal became loose after a little bit more drilling, which, as you can see now, make life quite a bit easier. So I shall drill on. You can see how far down I've gone. That's the top of the piezo crystal. It's a lot easier if I can get the crystal out, so I'm going to try and use an easy out. See if I can get in there and just pop it out. See how we get on. There it is. Alright, so now. Should be any difference in the availability of the hole. It's a lot easier to drill it out now. So back to the drill, back to the M12 bit. Okay, I've gone as far as I can go using the drill bit. Using the magnetic picker, obviously clearing the swarf out, it's very important to clear the swarf out every, as soon as you take the drill out almost, clean the swarf out. But I removed a, like a sort of diffuser, which obviously has made it easier for the drill to go in further than it has, and this little washer was also there, so I managed to remove that. Made life a bit easier. As I said, I can't emphasise enough, for the majority of people will realise the whys and wherefores. as you can see, that's how far down I am. I've come right up to the chuck. I'm just shy of 60, just shy of 60 mil. That's as far as I can drill for now. So obviously I'm gonna tap it and put the rod back in there and pull it. There we go. Right. As you can see, I can't get a lot further with the tap. So, I run the risk of skinning my knuckles, so I'm going to take it back out and put the stud in. Right. That's the my tensile bolt. Obviously, with the pulley system, rubber bands. Right. Start the apply some pressure. Let's see what happens. Right. That's under a huge amount of strain. I've got a 2.5 foot half inch breaker bar on it. And I'm giving it a huge amount of welly. And it's only a matter of time till something goes. The only problem is, because I'm here on my own, if it does go, and it goes on like a rocket, I'm either going to end up knocking the tooth out, getting concussed, or something. So I'm going to replace this assembly. It's definitely working, it will definitely work. It's not a one-man job. So I'm going to replace it with the hydraulic assembly just for the sake of safety. Right. Bolt still in there, but I've replaced it with the hydraulic puller. Still got the rubber bands on. Just be on the safe side. So, get on and bash away. There we go. That's the core. Just gone this second, under a lot of strain. As I said, I still think two people doing it. With a manual tool, it'll go. Took a bit of stick. It's gone. Gonna release that, take that piece off, and then I'll video what's left. Right, this is the piece that's just pulled out. That's the oldest left. We just need to take out this remaining piece. That will then allow the head, the cam carrier, to be separated from the head. Then the head can be removed and it can be put on a bench, and these remnants, of which there's one in here, one in there, can be done at sort of chest height. You can do them on a pillar drill, you can you do a multitude of things with them, but whilst they're as they are awkward bloody things. But yeah, fortunately two came out. That one there came out completely, and that one there came out completely. Just got to mess around with these. That one there. And that one. And I shall shortly show you the my method for getting this one. Right. That piece, the collar, is this piece over here. That's 19mm internal, and the ideal and external, if you take it out, if you actually take the core out, the external diameter of the core is 24mm. So the ideal size to tap that to is 22mm. So I'm using a 22 times 1.5, so there's 22 diameter, and the thread pitch is 1.5. The ideal diameter in order to be able to tap it is 19.5 mil. Unfortunately, I haven't got a 19.5 mil drill bit. So, what I've devised is use a little drill bit just to sort of put a chamfer on the top. Then start to open it up using the 22 by 1.5 tap. Once it's started to open up slightly, then I use a hole saw, which is this one here. That one. which is readily available, made by Bosch. I don't know if you can see the size, 20 mil, yeah. And basically you just sort of buzz it straight down the hole, tap it, and then I've made a an adapter, which is over here, which is this fella, which obviously is 22 times 1.5, and this end is 14 by 1.5, which means it will fit straight into the tool we've already got, and that's it. So I shall get on and make a start on that. I've put a slight chamfer on the top, and I said that will just allow the tap to make a start in there, just to open it up, just a fraction, just enough for the whole saw to get it to sort of centre itself. Here we go. With the whole saw, I need to go down as far as possible, and there we are. See how far down I've gone. Now it's just a case of tapping. I know it isn't pretty, but I don't think it's overly critical. Alright, that's been tapped down to there. I'm hoping that's enough. It started getting a bit awkward. If it does need to be tapped some more, I'll have to remove the wastegate actuator, because that was stopping the tapping tool from rotating freely. But it should be okay, taking into account the fact that the piece that's being inserted is only that deep, so whatever the case, the thread in there needs to be no deeper than that for the time being. So I'm about to screw that in and pull it out. I was hoping to use the manual pulling tool to show that it works. Unfortunately, by the time the assembly goes on and the nut goes on it, there's not going to be enough thread sat on the top for it to do the job, I don't think. I'll give it a go, but I don't think this, I think it's going to end up being a bit too short. But there we are. We'll see. Assembly on the top. There's just about enough, I think. So we'll give it a go. As you can see, it's lifted. So, I'll carry on winding it out. It shows these injectors can be got out in the absence of an hydraulic puller. Yeah. Yeah. There it is. Well, I hope that's helped someone. Leave any comments, any suggestions, any questions, I'll try and help out. Thank you. There it is. I hope that's helped someone. Leave any comments, any suggestions, any questions, I'll try and help out. Thank you. Further to my previous video, as I hope you can see, I've managed to remove one of the lower parts of the injector. So, having worked out the easiest way, the tooling, the best method, etc., I'm going to film the removal of this one. So stay tuned. As you can see, it was reasonably successful. Managed to pull out a lot of components.
an assortment there of broken bits of injector that, managed to come out with a lot of resistance. Right, firstly, I bought a 19mm, I only went for Starrett because the 19 diameter, this is a 19mm, the 19 diameter is true all the way up. I looked at some other hole saws and the 19mm had a tendency of flaring at that point, which I thought may have inhibited it going into the injection well. But this started life as, I got the whole saw, found, still a bit of injector in there, found the required thread, and this basically is a hold, an old head bolt, which is, forgive me this. Which started life as that. Correct thread, hardened. I removed the cut bolt on the top of the hex, filed this away. Well, fortunately I was able to do it on my lathe, but the lathe isn't a lot good, but you could do it by putting this end in a drill, and a file, just filing that down, or a grinder. It needs to be reasonably smooth in order to keep the hole saw central. Obviously that gets threaded on, and then I put a retaining bolt. I managed to find a bolt that was also the correct thread, put that on there, and then lock these two together, and that in turn obviously goes into the drill. But in order to keep that centered, previously I got one of the injector sleeves, which I cleaned up again just using a file and sandpaper, I think. And then I got a small piece of tube, approximately, I can't remember the length, but this was machined down to 19mm. Again, it was very close. This, I've no doubt the 19mm could be bought pre-made, and that was drilled out to 10mm, which allowed the two to go in, and using a 10mm assembly, a 10mm drill bit, that would effectively give you a hole centre. From there, go on there. And as you can see, that was your nice centre. And then once, obviously this piece just goes into the drill. But I found that they need to be pre-assembled. Yeah, as I said, pre-assembled, like that. Only because the locking up prevents the inner tube from traveling down, but providing the outer tube slides over, which it does, it should be a center, and then effectively that will go into the drill. And that allows you to drill the lower part of the core, which in this case is this assembly, which is 19mm. Which, see, on the cleaned up part is that one. It allows you to go down. You can comfortably get as far as this point here, which then allows you to remove a lot of this, which is causing all manner of complications. Right, so we'll get on with it, and you can have a look when it's done. Right, just a quick one. As you can see, that's the sleeve that I've cleaned up, gone back in, and there's the drill with the little boss ready to go. Okay. Right. You can see how the hole saw's starting to make an impact. Obviously still got a little way to go yet, but there it goes. Right. And that was after 20 seconds of drilling. There you go. Well, I've been doing this for probably 20 minutes, can't see it particularly well. You can see we're getting a nice groove down the side there, probably past the top of the injector. Down the side there, the channel down the side should probably be about 15mm deep. I wouldn't think I've got a lot further to go, but I just thought I'd show you how it's working. There you go. It's so difficult to get perception with these things. Yeah. Okay. Okay. I drilled as deep as I could, or as deep as I thought I could. I couldn't go much deeper because I was starting to run out of hole saw. And then getting a punch and a hammer, I just gave it a couple of gentle taps to loosen it. Carried along those pliers, lifted it out of the top, and there it is. As you can see now, we're now down to the internal, all the internal bits and pieces which we're going to lift out, and I'll show you how to remove the next piece. Okay. And that's just to show the sort of depth I drilled. I'll go back in there. You can see that was sat there, roughly. I could have got a little bit deeper, but I was, to be honest with you, I was getting concerned that I wasn't chasing my tail. But as I said, got that far. That was sat obviously like that. Just got a punch and just carefully tapped it left and right until it became loose, and then got a pair of long nose pliers that pulled it out. And this retainer, this sort of valve body retainer, came with it, fortunately. Okay. This shows what should come out below that piece. You should have this plate. That's just like effectively a little tube, like a little guidance tube for the spring. There's the needle. At the moment, this is a needle out of one of the other injectors, because I'm struggling to get the needle out of the injector I'm working on at the moment. I should persevere, but it's just to show what you need to get out ideally in order to be able to proceed. Okay. And they're all magnetic, nothing non-ferrous, everything's magnetic, so with a little bit of perseverance it should all lift out. There we are. Incidentally, whilst you were using the hole saw, or whilst I was using the hole saw, it was in order to prevent the hole saw from burning out, I made a point of sort of drilling for 10 seconds, slow with a lot of pressure, and then removing the assembly and then getting an air line. Because obviously after a while with the depth, the magnetic pickup tool wasn't capable of picking the debris up. Regarding removing the needle out of the bottom of the injector nozzle at the bottom, again, a little bit of compressed air just to sort of make sure that there's no debris left in there, and then careful placement with the tool, and there it is, came out. Right, for the next part, what I did was I took this assembly, I cut the two slightly longer prongs off using a grinder, and then carefully welded that to a piece of rod, which gave me this. I welded it to the rod very carefully. You probably braze it if you've got brazing equipment, and then put a little bend on the end there. And the idea is that will go into the nozzle body, which I'm just looking for now. There we go. There's one. That'll go into. What's left in the bottom of the injector at the moment, and the placement of these pins allows you to locate it within the injector and then carefully loosen it, at which point, once you're able to loosen it, I effectively, there's a special tool that you can buy that I carefully went in with an easy out, and it came out. And there's a separate video clip that I took yesterday for the other injector that I was doing to show that. But I'll crack on with this now and get back to you.
Right. Already loosened it slightly, but this is in effect what you're looking for. So that piece in the hole, you see I've got a small socket on there. So you're starting to get a little bit, just allowing that piece to rotate within the base of the tube. What I did yesterday when I did the other injector was I poured a small amount of acetone, thinners, standard thinners, petrol I'd imagine, probably diesel, anything to there. One, it allows a little bit of lubrication between the nozzle body and the nozzle body holder, if you like, the lower part of the injector nozzle. But it also allows the carbon deposit to break up slightly, which does make it easier to get the nozzle out. So here we go. M7 by M7 by the oven with a disappearing door that slides effortlessly under the cavity. So get comfort to your cooking with Neff. Search Neff ingredients. M7 by 0.7. That's what that is. It's an M7 by 0.7. So 7.07 thread pitch. That's a quarter drive, I believe it's a 6mm. Yeah, 6mm. That was a 1/4 to 3/8 adapter, a do it however you see fit. And obviously, I'll just put the drive attachment in the drill. Speed 1, loads of weight, steady she blows. And then periodically just put it out and check, and eventually you should get this piece out, as I did. We're now ready to drill and tap. Well, not even drill, just tap. And if I remember rightly, that's M16 by 1.5. And so I'll crack on with that now and get back to you. I incorrectly said that that needs tapping at M16. It's not, it's 18. M18 by 1.5 is how I've done it. I mean, you know, if you're able to do it a different way, then do it. But I managed to get a first tap, which obviously makes it easier to start the hole. Then a second tap, which allows you to kind of close the lower section of the thread. Which is here. So this is the primary tap. And as you can see, it's designed to start the hole. The problem is when you come to tap it, you've only got a small amount of thread because a lot of this is wasted thread. You can't actually tap into it. You can't screw a bolt into there. I'll then use the second, which takes you closer to the bottom, and then finally, I think they call it a plug, and it allows you to get the thread almost right to the very bottom. So I'll be using these three on that hole and pulling the bugger out. Okay. Obviously, just thought I'd highlight, because length is an issue, because we're now starting to get quite deep into the head. What I've done is I've taken a 12-sided 13mm socket, and the 18mm tap sits in there quite nicely with an extension bar. This is a 1/2 inch. The one behind is the 16mm, which I had to use for the lower part of the nozzle body, which I suspect will still remain stuck. The lower part of the nozzle body is this fella here. So if we do get down to this point, then it will be M16, whereas the one that we're doing, which is this piece, is M18. So this is with the first tap, just showing that it all fits in there quite nicely. Unfortunately, these sockets, the further down they go, especially when you get into the base of the nozzle, they're handy because they actually give you a centre in the hole. Makes life considerably easier. Alright, so I'll just carry on tapping this one. Alright, that's the hole drilled and tapped. And the hole gone. And by using the three sets of taps, that's allowed me to sort of get a thread right down to the very bottom. I'll get the borescope in a minute, and maybe I'll see it from there actually. But I'll set the borescope up so you can see the depth of the thread. Okay. As you can see, the thread's right down to the bottom of the hole. That's a much better shot. And that allows us obviously to get as much purchase on as much material as possible. Stand a much better chance of pulling bigger pieces out rather than all the silly little pieces. For the purposes of perspective, just to show whereabouts we're threaded from below the thread line there, the thread internal, and this point here. So we're threaded approximately that sort of distance there. Hoping by pulling this it will pull this piece as well. But as you can see on the previous attempt, that piece remained where it was. Right, here we are back at the kit. This is M18 by 1.5, which is obviously ideal. A lot of these pieces in here I've cut various ends off just to allow me to get a purchase on this particular type of injector. As you can see, the thread isn't brilliant. It's whereabouts I pulled out the one there, so I think it's okay. Worst case scenario, I'll just have to re-tap it, just run a die down it just to sort of tidy the thread up, but effectively that goes into the hole that we've just and obviously it's a case of getting it nice and tight, tightening up on there, and then putting the puller assembly over the top. As I said, this can be done. If this was made M18 by 1.5 rod, high tensile, 16 and 14 are all available online. They can all be bought, so you don't have to use this. You can still use the manual puller, the Renault tool. I'm still confident that it will work. I'm just, for the purposes of expedition, my interest is to actually get my injectors out of my engine. Hence the reason I'm working with what I've got. But as you saw in the previous video, I've already shown that certain sections of the job, can comfortably be done with the available kit in that kit that comes from Renault. But as I said, if you were to buy, they can be bought in as small as 300 mil lengths. If a piece of M18, M16, and M14, obviously the thread pitch would have to be respective of the dies that you, the taps that you've got. I'm going for the 1.5 just because I've got them. A lot of these are already 1.5. That's a 1.5 on there. It's an M16 1.5. As I said, they're already available, and with a little bit of careful work and ingenuity, they can be tapped and what have you, re-threaded to suit the available kit. But there we are, anyway. That's that piece of threaded bar, which is M18 by 1.5 on the bottom to go into the hole we just tapped. These are the upstands, the retainers from the actual Renault kit. The ones that you may have seen me using previously, one of the bolts snaps in the bottom, so I had to revise. This piece here is an extender that I've made, but it actually came from the handle of a slide hammer. It just, fortunately, it was the same thread. But you can buy M16,
again by 1.5 connectors. They just look like big nuts with holes in the middle with a thread. The only issue you may possibly have with those is how they'd actually go through this hole. So you may have to sort of, get a file on it, maybe open this one up, open those up, I don't know. But as I said, but in this instance, that's M16 by 1.5. That just effectively drops on there. In turn, this is one of the pieces that I cut the end off of. And just ran it flat on the bottom. And that goes into the top, which gives me enough extension that I can put the plate over the top. That's probably needs adjusting, but just to give you an idea, that piece there I've machined. Can't get it in the hole, but you can see that's been machined to go inside this hole. The problem that I have got is that that will catches the underside of the hydraulic puller. So I have to use a second plate just to give me the additional height. This is one from one kit, and the other one I use is the one from the Renault kit. But it's on the pieces that I was using previously, I made these little adapters. It's just a hole in the bottom there that goes over that peg. So I may actually use those. So take those off of this one. As you can see, they bent. That was one of my previous attempts at trying to get the injectors out. The purpose for this being machined down, it didn't work. It turned out to be a waste of time. This is the only method that's worked so far, the one I'm currently doing. But they will give me the additional height to allow me to raise this plate up to somewhere up here, which will allow this to move within the puller, be it mechanical or hydraulic. All right, so I shall get on and attach this as I need to, remove these possibly, but I'll turn the video back on, you'll see that. Okay, ready for the pull. As you can see, I took these extenders off of the other uprights and put them onto these to give me the additional height. There's the extender, which as I said, I made out of an old slide hammer handle. Obviously the puller, the rubber bands for purposes of safety. Right, here we go. Right, I've pulled that piece. You see, that's what's just come out. They're missing out there. And again, just for the purposes of perspective, the piece that's just been removed is this piece. That piece there. And the piece that's remaining is this piece, which is that fellow there, which I shall get on and tap. And that's M16 by 1.5, same method, same story. Sorry, I'm just trying to find the I'm just showing you, it's gone into a 13mm socket. Oh, 11mm socket. Yeah. Into an 11mm socket. Again, half inch drive. Okay. Drilled I've tapped the hole, M16 1.5. I was just going to highlight the fact these are the taps from a cheapy set. They're not overly expensive. I've gone through a couple of them in the past, but I don't know if you can see right on that edge there. See, it's shiny on that edge there. That's whereabouts it's blunted these bits out. I found it started struggling, so I've been against the idea of actually putting oil into the hole for the purposes of tapping, purely because it'll hold the swarf in the injector well, which I don't want to do. So I got a brush, placed a little bit of oil on the end of the brush, and I've actually brushed these threads, and it's made a considerable difference on this particular hole. It's the first time I've tried it on this hole, but on this particular hole it's made quite a difference. The other taps, the 18s and various others that I've got, have been replacements for these from this set.
that have they've either chipped. I've got the M14 I was using in the previous video chipped on one of these teeth, which made it difficult. They blunt out. I think that the lower part of the body, this, is made of a harder material than the stuff that's above it. Because this seems to be a lot easier to tap, it seems to do a lot less damage. But the moment you get into this, it's quite a hard material. And I think due to again, with this, the tack that I've just used, you can see a thread there of sorts. It's not too good, but it's much the same principle as we were doing previously. There we are, you can see a thread better there. The only thing that I've had to take into account now is that the M16 1.5 that I've just used is a first. It's the initial tap. So obviously this area here, when this hits the bottom of the injector body, which it does, this point back to here has got no thread. There's nothing at all to get a purchase on. So obviously it's imperative to try and get down as deep as you can in order to get as much thread on the nozzle cap that I showed. In order to maximise the purchase of the bolt when we put the bolt in for pulling it. Okay. These two bolts are two that came out of the set. I've come to the conclusion that the adapters that they had on the bottom of them aren't adapters that I'm likely to use, so I've sacrificed them. What I'm in, the longer one of the two, into the hole. Obviously tightened down by the usual method, but once these are in, I don't think I need the extension. I may do. Right, I changed my mind. This is the shorter bar of the two. Obviously M16 all the way down to go into the M16 hole we've just drilled. This is the extender, the adapter that I made out of a side hammer handle. Just a longer bar, obviously that could be any length. And the extenders that I made for these uprights, which as you can see is kind of giving me ideal heights for pulling and whatever. Okay. Obviously this is as it was, but it's just to show with the puller on the top, and the bands, and the ram. Start pumping. Here we are, the final piece. The basic injector. It's just pulled it out now, it's just gone ping, just taken all the bits out. You can see. The only thing obviously that's left in there on both of these I've got to work out is the copper sealing washer on the bottom. Got to work out some way of getting it out, I'm not even sure how to do it. But that was the last of my worries until the injectors and the injector bodies and all the associated injector bits were out. I wasn't too worried. But there you are, I hope that's helped someone. Good luck. Just remember that this is only how I did it. You may find a better way of doing it, you may want to follow this. The one thing I will say is if you do attempt to remove your injectors, using this as a, not as an instructable, but as a guide. The one thing I'll say is everything slow, steady, don't rush anything. The drilling, lots of pressure, nice and slow. Spend plenty of time clearing the swarf from the holes, and everything should go okay. Thanks again. Bye.